Hi, I'm Florian Kohler, ESPN Trick Shot Magic Champion, and today I'm going to teach you the basics of pool. In order to play pool, you will need a few things. First off, a pool table. In this case, the iPhone pool table made in France by Cornilleau. You're going to need, of course, pool cues right here. Those are going to come standard in the package when you buy the table. You're going to, of course, need a set of balls right here. In this case, we have from 1 to 15 plus the cue ball. That way you can play both 8 ball and 9 ball. You're going to need a few racks. In this case, the 8 ball triangle, the 9 ball triangle, which is the lozenge. And then lastly, you're going to need chalk. So in this case, we have a gray chalk because the felt is gray. But you know, if you have a different color, the chalk is usually matching the color of the felt. In order to play pool properly, you need three things: a good bridge, a solid stance, and a great stroke. Let's start with the bridge first. The closed bridge, probably one of the easiest and most common bridge in pool. The idea with a closed bridge is basically to put the cue in between these three fingers there. So the index, second finger there, and the thumb right here, and sort of like make a contact point. The idea is to not have a huge gap like this so the cue doesn't do that. If you look at the palm, always try to put part of the palm on the table for solidity. So always try to keep as much in the hand as possible, sort of a small bend in the forearm, and just make that contact right here. That triangle here is very important. If you need to raise it, we can go like this. However, it's a little more difficult, but it works as well. Let's cover the open bridge now. So open bridge, hand full flat on the table to start. And all you gotta do is raise your thumb like this here, and you're gonna make a groove in between your index and your thumb right there. So that's the standard open bridge. The more solid your bridge is, the better of a player you're gonna be. Let's go over the rail bridge now. So here's first one of the misconceptions in pool that I've seen quite often, is when the cue ball is frozen to the rail, some people have a tendency to like always open it up because they say it's too hard to hit the ball or whatever. It does not have to be. A rail shot is really easy, a rail bridge. So the ball frozen to the rail here. You're simply gonna do sort of an open bridge. I kind of bend those two fingers for stability, and you're pretty much right on. If needed, if the ball is a little further this way, you can also do this, which is pretty simple. Just those two fingers here, thumb right in there, and again, you make a groove. This also works. And if you keep your hands really flat, you can still see the ball, and you have good action and good aiming with the ball. So those are, to me, the three most common type of bridges. The stance. The stance is a really important part of your pool game because with a good stance and a good bridge, you really will be naturally a good player. So let's talk about the feet. There's different position depending on the game, snooker, pool, or English pool. While a snooker stance is gonna be more facing the table, a pool stance is more like this, and since we're playing pool, this is gonna be our stance for today. The idea is to find a comfortable in between your leg distance, which is something like this. You definitely don't want to be like this, and you don't want to be like this. So you just got to find sort of a natural opening here. I would say the first feet is always aiming a little bit this way, not like this, not like this either. So again, more of the natural aspect of it. And then the next part is going to be the bending. So you're going to always bend more this knee than this one. You can have a little bend in this knee, it's acceptable, especially if the table is a little lower. But ideally, the perfect position is like this. So this one goes a little bent, and this one more straight, while this leg is facing this way. Okay, now that the feet are covered, you're also looking at all this forearm, shoulder, back on the arm, like this. So we have our bridge, we have the pool table, the pool ball on the table, we're going down, a little bent in the forearm on the front on the left one, and now we gotta look at this. So all this arm, the forearm, is going to be perpendicular to the cue and facing straight to the floor, like this. The ideal is for the elbow not to drop, but just move like this, in a straight line. And this is pretty much a good pool stance. Let's not talk about the stroke. This is the last part of your fundamental, also very important. For a good stroke, you also assume you have a decent bridge and a decent feet position already. That taken out of the way, the idea is for your backhand to be very loose. So you never want to be like this. It's just really bad for you because it's going to result in you doing bad stuff in front, meaning you're going to miss the point of contact either left, right, or front, or high or low. So you want it to basically be only one or two finger, all the back fingers especially being pretty loose. This is gonna help you to follow through, it's gonna help you to add action to the cue ball, and it's gonna do a lot of things really for you in your ball control. Okay, now that it's done, we kind of sort of already talked about it in the stance before, but you're looking at this arm here, and as you can see in this view, it's even better. You can see my forearm is gonna have to be perpendicular to the surface of the table at the point of impact, like this, okay? So remember, loose grip, arm perpendicular. You also don't want this movement with your wrist, this is really bad. You also don't want this. So ideally, if you can have just a straight line with everything, it's pretty good. Now the rest on your stroke, depending also how tall or small you are, short you are, you're gonna have to be either lower or higher on the cue. So it's not impossible to be like that. However, I'm better here because I think I see the cue more. So again, this is something you're gonna have to be comfortable with. And while some people are more comfortable low, most people are more medium. So this is just something you're gonna have to work on yourself. And just remember the cue parallel to the table, this arm perpendicular, all in a straight line, don't drop the elbow, and you should be having a solid stroke as well.